Good morning, students. Welcome back to your maths class. Children, we'll start exercise 14.3 today. We have 1 to 5 questions only. Then rest of the questions are cut. So question number 1, 2, 3, these are related to the bar graph, which you have already done in your junior classes. So you will make bar graph yourself. Now question number 4 and 5, these two questions are related to the histogram. This is a new topic for you. Then in histogram, that is similar to the bar graph, the difference between bar graph and histogram is this only, that in bar graph we have gap between the bars, but in histogram there is no gap. So I am taking question number 5. In question number 5, it's given to you, the following table gives the lifetimes of 400 neon lamps. You have to represent this data on graph. Now, if in exam it's not given to you by which method you have to draw, then the procedure will be, you have to check first of all, if the class intervals are given to you, then you have to draw histogram. Clear? So this way you can identify which graph you have to draw. Now it's given to you lifetime of the 400 neon lamps is given. Lifetime in hours 300 to 400. Number of lamps are 14. 400 to 500, that is 56. Then 500 to 600 lamps are 60. 6 to 7, 86. 7 to 8, 74. 800 to 900, 62, and 900 to 1000, that is 48. So this you have to represent on graph. Now first of all, just check, our table is starting from 300. So first of all, when we will start making the graph, what we have to do, we have to use kink. Now just see this way, you will draw the graph. We'll use the kink because our data is starting from 300. So 300 to 400, just see the gap is of 100, so 300, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 we'll be taking on x-axis. Means the lifetime in hours we'll be taking on x-axis and number of lamps we'll be taking on y-axis. The procedure is same, 300 to 400, so our data is number of lamps are 14. So we'll draw our first bar, then 400 to 500, our lamps are 56. We'll draw this one, 56. Now just see, there is no gap in between. Clear? So this way you will use your table and represent it on the graph. Now 500 to 600. These are 60 lamps, so we will represent 60. Then 6 to 700, these are 86. So we will take 86 and we will draw our bar. Next 700 to 800, 74. So we will use 700 to 800, we will take 74 on y-axis and we will draw the bar. Then 800 to 900, that is 62. And last is 900 to 1000, that is 48. So we will draw this one. So this way you have to represent your data on the graph. So this is called histogram. Now in question number 4. Now come to the question number 4. It's given to you the length of 40 leaves of a plant are measured correct in the millimeter. Now just check this table. 118 to 126, 127 to 135. This is not a continuous class interval. So what you will do? First of all, you will make this class intervals continuous. How? By adding the 0.5 in the highest observation and by subtracting the 0.5 from the lowest observation. This way. Procedure, I have already told you. 117.5 to 126, because the gap between these two, 126 and 127, the gap is 1, so divided by 2, 0.5. So we'll add 0.5 in the highest observation, and we'll be subtracting 0.5 from the lowest observation. So our table will be 117.5 to 126.5, 126.5 to 135.5, 135.5 to 144.5, 144.5 to 153.5, 153.5 to 162.5. So this is the table which you have to represent on the graph with the help of histogram. So same way in this also, our table is starting from 117, so we will use the king. So children, you have to complete question number 1 to 5 of this exercise. Thank you. Have a nice day.